हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज ओम प्रकाश, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, कृष्णा इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, सो लेट्स डाइव डीप इनटू द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट। ए स्मॉल रिकैप अबाउट व्हाट वी हैव सीन सो फार इज थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, व्हाट इज थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, व्हाट इज द सिस्टम ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, व्हाट आर द साइकल्स ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, what is isentropic process, what is intrinsic or extrinsic processes or properties, what is path function, what is point function, what is work done, what is enthalpy, what is entropy or what is heat transfer. So far as concerned with all the thermodynamic properties like temperature, volume, pressure, density and variation of temperature with respect to the processes and path, we have seen. Now I will see one of the most important topic in thermodynamics, which is applied of the first law of thermodynamics to the non-flow processes. That is, our topic will be first law of thermodynamics applied to non-flow processes. But before going to the lecture, we should understand what is system. So we have seen any specified region where we apply the thermodynamics concept or thermodynamic properties is called system, like temperature, pressure and volume. And we have seen what is energy, what is energy transfer and what is the relationship between the energy transfer or energy balance equation. So far we have seen all these concepts. Here what we will see, a small recap about the topic or in this volume what we are going to discuss is what are the thermodynamic processes and their behavior or characteristic or thermodynamic properties, thermodynamics properties with respect to all the processes. Those processes will be non-flow processes or a process where we are going to apply the thermodynamic properties where there is not transfer of mass, but there may be process, there may be chances of transfer of energy. That is, in a small cap, we can call it as a closed system. So we are going to apply all these thermodynamic properties and processes and discuss holistic manner in a closed system. So let us discuss what is thermodynamic processes and which processes we are going to discuss. So first one is constant volume process. Constant volume process, or it is also called as isochoric process. Isochoric process. Second one, where we will apply thermodynamics equation, is constant pressure. Constant pressure process. Constant pressure process, that is isobaric process. This is isobaric process. Third one is constant temperature process, or it is called as isothermal process. Isothermal process. Fourth one is constant entropy process, and fourth one is polytropic process. So we will see what is constant volume process or isochoric, constant pressure process or isobaric, constant temperature process or this is isothermal process, constant entropy process and polytropic process. We will see what is all these processes and the behavior with respect to temperature, pressure, what is enthalpy change, what is entropy change, what is total work done, what is heat transfer, what is internal energy change in case of all these processes. So our what will be the steps we are going to discuss is, First of all, we will see definition. Definition. Second one will be PV and TS diagram. PV and TS diagram. Third one will be thermodynamic. Thermodynamic properties or relations. Properties or relations. Or relations. Fourth one will be work done or change in heat transfer or heat transfer change. Third one will be change in enthalpy, change in entropy, and change in internal energy and change in entropy. So these five formulas will be the main course or main thing which we are going to discuss. So first of all, we will see definition of constant volume process, and then we will discuss PV and TS diagram, how we can describe PV and TS diagram for each of these processes separately, and thermodynamic properties or relations, means what is temperature and pressure relation of state 1 or state 2, or work done, change in heat transfer, change in enthalpy, change in entropy, and change in internal energy. So far as concerned, I have told you that we are going to apply first law of thermodynamics in case of all these four or five processes. So first of all, we should understand what is first law of thermodynamics. That is del Q equals to del W in a closed cycle. Means, suppose any thermodynamic process is undergoing in a closed cycle, or in a cycle, you can call it a cycle, then total heat transfer will be total work done in that particular cycle. So we will apply del Q equals to cyclic integral of del Q equals to cyclic integral of del W. Means total heat transfer will be equal to total work done in case of all these cyclic processes. But it will be applied only for the cyclic process. If it will be non-cyclic, we cannot apply it. So here, first of all, we will discuss about what is constant volume process or isochoric process. So in case of isochoric process, our quick recap will be the definition, then PVTS diagram, thermodynamic properties, and W12 and all. So, my dear friends, first of all, we will see what is the definition of constant volume process. So, if any system of gas undergoes in such a way that the total volume during the process will be constant, is called as constant volume process or isochoric process. For example, a pressure cooker or a gas cylinder. That is where we can apply the concept of constant volume process. So we will see what is PV and TS diagram in case of constant volume process. As we can see, that is it is a constant volume process. So here a constant volume process may be classified or may be drawn like this. 1, 2, 2. Where volume is constant. Here V1 equals to V2. This is a constant volume process, and when we draw a dotted line with the pressure or vertical line, we can see it as P1 and P2. So clearly we can see that in a constant volume process, which is 1 to 2, which is V1 equals to V2, undergoing with the pressure change P1 and P2. Means here only volume is constant, pressure is not constant. So when we draw this PV diagram into the TS diagram, and when we recap or when we draw this PV into TS, what we can see is the constant volume process will be like this, which is maintained at two pressure, which is P1 and P2, which is maintained at P1 and P2, and this is called constant volume process or isochoric process. So here it is 1 and this is 2. My dear students, we can see that at point number 1, what we can call it as P1, and at point 2 is T2. So we can clearly see that there is a change in temperature or there is a sudden drop in temperature. So here we are discussing PV and TS diagram. So here it is PV and TS diagram. In case of cooling, in case of cooling process, that is constant volume cooling process drawn on PV and TS diagram. Now we have seen what is the definition which has been gone under process where constant volume, that is volume is constant, and we have seen PV and TS diagram in case of isochoric process. Now we will see what is thermodynamic properties relations. So what thermodynamic properties relations? As we have seen that it is a process where gas has been taken as a fluid or working substance. So in case of gas, what we have seen is PV equals to mRT. PV equals to mRT. For ideal gas equation, we know that PV equals to mRT. It means at all the state or state transformation, when we are taking one as a consideration, what will happen? PV equals to constant here, or P1 V1 equals to mRT1. In case of two, what will happen? P2 V2 equals to mRT2. We can say P1 V1 equal to mRT1 and P2 V2 equal to mRT2 at point number two, and this is at point number one. It means when there will be a circulation of air or whatever the fluid will be, that is gas, total pressure and volume multiple equals to mass and R and T1. R is characteristic gas constant. R bar is universal gas constant and R is characteristic gas constant. We calculate R as R upon R bar upon M, that is molar mass. R bar is R bar value we have given, universal gas constant, and M is molar mass of the particular gas. When we are taking nitrogen or oxygen or air, we can divide molecular mass of the particular gases to the R bar. So we can calculate R of that particular gas or characteristic gas constant. So here P1 V1 equal to mRT1 or P2 V2 equal to mRT2. Suppose we are dividing P1 V1 upon P2 V2, this will be equals to mRT1 upon mRT2. But my dear students, we have seen that we are discussing about the constant volume process or isochoric process where the system has undergone at constant volume. Means volume will be constant. If volume will be constant, what we can say is V1 equals to V2 or V1 equals to V2. When we are applying V1 equals to V2 on this particular equation, what we are getting is P1 upon P2 equals to mRT1 upon T2. But it will be T1 upon T2. Why? Because MR and this MR gets cancelled. Why it is getting cancelled? Because the gas which is circulating from point number 1 to 2 is of the same gas which is circulating which is getting inserted at point 1 and getting exit at point 2. So mass will be constant, and R, that is characteristic gas constant. If the working fluid or working gas is air, then R or characteristic gas constant will be constant at point number 1 as well as point number 2. So mass time characteristic as constant at point 1 and 2 will be constant. So it gets cancelled. In that case, what will happen? P1 upon V1 equals to T1 upon T2. This is the relation, or we can also call it as P1 upon T1 equals to P2 upon T2. This is the characteristic equation or thermodynamic equation in case of constant volume process. Now we will see work done, change in heat transfer, enthalpy, change in internal energy, and change in entropy. So let us see each of these formulas in case. So far we have said what is the thermodynamic processes. There are infinite number of thermodynamic processes, but for the sake of thermodynamics or for the thermodynamic equation or engine, we can see only 5 processes which have been drawn into the board. Now we will see what is total work done. So here we can draw PV diagram. We can draw PV diagram again. PV diagram in case of constant volume process. It is PV diagram 1, 2, 2. What we can say is total work done is, or total work done can be calculated with the total area which it is covered on PV diagram. Total area which it covers on PV diagram is called as total work done. So clearly we can see that 1, 2, 2 is a straight line which covers no area. So work done will be 0. But we will see this work done in case of first law of thermodynamics applied to non-flow process. So work done in case of non-flow process is P dV 1 to 2. Means what will be the total work done? Total work done will be when the working fluid or gas is moving or transformed from point number 1 to 2, which is state 1, this is state 1, and this is state number 2. State 1 and state 2. We have seen already what is state, or when transformation of the state takes place, then a process occurs. Or this is isochoric process. Isochoric process. So in case of isochoric process, which is taking transforms of the states from 1 to 2, total work done is taken as work done W1 to 2 is equal to P times dV or 1 to 2. So here we have seen what is total work done. So we will calculate the total work done in case of constant volume process with the help of this formula. So my dear friends, you can see that here the V1 equals to V2 or dV equals to 0. Why? Because there is no change of volume, because it is undergoing in a constant volume process. So when there will be a constant volume process, dV will be 0 or work done will be 0. W12 equals to 0. My dear students, one thing you should keep into your mind is you cannot write W12 as W1 minus W2. You cannot write it as W1 minus W2. Why? Because work done is a path function. It is a path function. In case of path function, we cannot write W12 equals to W1 minus W2. When you are writing W1 minus W2, it directly indicates that work done is a point function. Means you can calculate work at the particular point, but which is not the case in the thermodynamics. So we cannot write W12 as this, or also we cannot write Q12 equals to Q1 minus Q2 because change in heat transfer is also a path function in case of thermodynamics. So we cannot write W12 equals to this one and Q12 equals to this one. So here in case of isochoric process, work done is 0. Now let's see what is change in internal energy, delta U. That is CV dT, or CV, that is specific heat at constant volume. CV dT is T2 minus T1 kilojoule per kg. Kilojoule per kg. T2 minus T1, which we have seen already in case of TS diagram. In case of TS diagram, it is T1 and it is T2. So this will be RCV T2 minus T1. What is changing? Heat transfer or dQ? dQ can be calculated as mCp or mC dT from point number 1 to 2, or mCv dT means change in temperature, that is T2 minus T1. What is enthalpy change or delta H? Delta H, delta H will be mC dT or delta T, or it is delta T, which will be mCv delta T. Now we can see what is entropy change, that is delta S. What will एम्प्टी एंट्रोपी चेंज डेल्टा एस, वी कैन कैलकुलेट डेल्टा एस एज डेल क्यू अपॉन टी फ्रॉम 1 to 2. साइक्लिक इंटीग्रल और इंटीग्रल फ्रॉम 1 to 2 डेल क्यू अपॉन टी विच इज डेल क्यू इज एम सी वी डीटी अपॉन टी फ्रॉम पॉइंट नंबर 1 to 2. When you integrate this, m and cv is constant, it will be m times cv and dt upon t from 1 to 2, or we can calculate or integrate it as m cv ln of t from 1 to 2. When you further integrate this, you can enter, you will find m cv ln of t2 upon this is change in entropy in case of isochoric process. So far, my dear students, we have seen what is isochoric process definition. It's PV relationship P1 equal to MRP1 and P2 equal to MRP2. We have divided it and we find the relation P1 upon T1 equals to P2 upon T2. And then we have seen what is the PV and TS diagram in case of isochoric process. And what is total heat transfer, what is total work done, and what is enthalpy and entropy. One important thing, here we can see that dq equals to du plus dw, or dw is 0 in case of constant volume process. So dq equals to du, or we have seen the same thing in case of this formula, that is dq equals to dq, which we have derived mcv delta t, and du, which is also mcv delta t. So in case of, so we can summarize isochoric process as constant heat transfer in case of constant volume or isochoric process. The change in internal energy will be equals to change in heat transfer, that is heat transfer change will be equals to total internal energy change in case of constant volume process. Now we will see what is constant pressure process. So our quick revision will be same definition, and then we will see the relationship between pressure and volume, temperature and all. First of all, so our second process is constant pressure, that is isobaric process, we will discuss isobaric as definition. Second one will be relation of P, V and T, and third one will be PV and TS diagram, and then we will see total what is del W, del Q, DU, DH, or what is delta S. So in case of constant pressure process, we will see all these four recap. So what is the definition of constant pressure process? So in case of constant pressure process, what will happen when any system undergoes into a constant pressure, or when there will be a pressure which is constant while transformation of process or while going processes from any point 1 to 2 is called as constant pressure process. So we have seen constant pressure process. Now we will say PV and TS diagram in case of constant pressure process. What is PV and TS diagram? Here is PV and this one is TS diagram. So in case of constant pressure, what we can see is a horizontal straight line which is 1 to 2. Or the state has been transformed from point number 1 to point number 2 in case of constant pressure process. So when any state is getting transformed from any point, it is called process, or it is constant pressure process, that is isobaric. here the total work done will be P times dP integral from point number 1 to 2. Now let us draw this 1 to 2 or isobaric process in TS diagram. What will happen? This will be something like this. This will be from 1 to 2 and constant volume, because it is a 1 to 2. So here it is volume 1 and volume 2. We can draw volume 1 and 2 like this is V1 and this one is V2. So from 1 to 2, it is going from V1 to V2. The constant pressure process line is 1 to 2. Or here it is temperature 1, or here it is temperature number 2. We can see that there is a change in temperature, or it is a rising temperature. So we can call it as where the total temperature is being increased in case of constant pressure process. Now we will see the relation of PV, pressure, volume and temperature. What will happen? Here it is P1, V1 equals to MRT1. Here it is P2, V2 equals to MRT2. Let us see the relation. P1, V1 upon P2, V2 equals to MRT1 upon MRT2. Or MR and MR will be constant, because whatever mass is getting entered at the point 1 is being exit at the point number 2. So mass will be constant. R will be also constant, which is characteristic as constant. Why it is constant? Because R is, what is R? Is R bar upon molar mass. R bar is universal gas constant, which is constant for all the gases, and the total molar mass, which is a particular gas getting entered at point number here and getting exit at point number 2. So molar mass will be constant. So total R will be also constant. So MR and MR gets cancelled here, and because it is a constant pressure process, so P1 equals to P2. Here what will happen? P1 equals to P2, because it is an isobaric process, because it is a constant pressure process. So P1 equals to P2. What will happen? This relation will be converted as P1 upon V2 equals to T1 upon T2, or V1 upon T1 equals to V2 upon T2. So in case of constant pressure process or isobaric process, the relation will be come out as V1 upon V2 equals to T1 upon T2, which is not the case of constant volume or isobaric process. Now we will see total work done and what will be delta W, delta Q, du, dh and delta S in case of constant pressure process. My dear students, we will classify it as total work done will be work done 1 to 2. 1 to 2 means total work done from point number 1 to 2, or when any point is moving from point number 1 to 2 at constant pressure, what will be the total work done in transforming point number 1 to 2, or transforming the state 1 to 2, what will be the total work done that we are going to derive. So W12 will be P dV 1 to 2, because in case of non-flow process, total work done is PdV, which we have seen in reciprocating piston cylinder device, or when we have discussed about what is reciprocating piston and cylinder, we have seen total work change, or in case of closed system, what is the total work done, that is 1 to 2. Or total work done is also area covered of that particular process in case of PV diagram. So we can see that in case of PV diagram, this is the total area which has been covered. So there is some particular amount of area which it is getting covered in case of PV diagram. So there will be certainly some amount of work done which was not in the case of isochoric or constant volume process, because in case of isochoric, we have seen or we have derived that total work done is 0. But here it is not the case, because here it is a constant pressure, so P will be constant, or P is coming out from the integral part 1 to 2, or dV. What is dV? Volume change, that is V1 to V2. When this state is transformed or getting some path from point 1 to 2, there will be some change of volume. That that is 1 to 2. So work done will be P of V2 minus V1. So there will be a work done in case of isobaric process, that is P of V2 minus V1. Or what is du? That is Cp dt. Why Cp dt? It is a specific heat at constant pressure. But in case of constant volume, it is Cp because specific heat at constant volume. So in case of pressure, it is specific heat at constant pressure, or the unit is kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So Cp dt or Cp dt. What is the temperature change? Because it is a in case of TS diagram, the curve is like this 1 to 2. So temperature 2 is higher or temperature 1 is lower. So it is Cp of E2 minus C1. Now we will see what is the change in heat transfer or dQ. dQ will be m Cp delta T from 1 to 2. M Cp delta T from 1 to 2. Or you can take m odd because dQ is del Q upon m. So we are taking heat flux or Cp dT. So here it will be also Cp of change of temperature, that is T2 minus T1. Now we will see what is the total entropy change. So entropy change will be del S, that is 1 to 2 m Cp delta T upon T, or we can derive this as m Cp because constant temperature, so it is coming on 1 to 2 or del Q upon T. This is simply del Q upon T, del Q upon T. M Cp 1 to 2 del T upon T, that is m Cp ln of T2 upon T1. M Cp ln of T2 upon T1. But in case of constant volume process, it is m Cp ln of T2 upon T1. But in case of constant pressure, m Cp ln of T2 upon T1. What is enthalpy change? Delta H, that is m Cp delta T. M Cp delta T. Because here it is a constant pressure. So far as concerned to the isobaric process, we have seen that two values are constant here. What are those two values? dQ and del H. dQ and del H. So, in case of isobaric process, what we can call it as, or in a quick recap, we can define substantially as the total change in heat transfer will be equal to total enthalpy change in case of isobaric process. But in case of isochoric or constant volume process, what we have seen? We have seen their dQ equals to dU. dQ equals to dU in case of isochoric process. In case of isochoric process. So, my dear students, we have seen what are the relationship of a pressure, volume, temperature, what is total work done, what is heat transfer, and what is enthalpy change, what is entropy change, what is the heat transfer change in case of constant volume and constant pressure process.